Dear students, today we will discuss centrifugal pump introduction, work done by the impeller of a centrifugal pump and efficiencies of a centrifugal pump. So let's start.
So at first, let's try to understand the main components of a centrifugal pump. That is impeller, casing, suction pipe, delivery pipe. So this is the block diagram of a centrifugal pump, where main components are shown here. So this portion is your casing, which is spiral in nature. Inside the casing you will find impeller. Then in the middle of that you will find the eye of the impeller. This is your suction pipe. This is your suction flange. Here vacuum gauze is there, vacuum gauze. This is your delivery pipe. This is delivery valve. Here you can put delivery suction valve also. This is your delivery flange, delivery valve. From this side to this one, it is your suction head. This is your delivery head. Basically, it will rotate in a clockwise direction depending upon the situation, or maybe anti-clockwise direction. And due to the force exerted here by the impeller, it produces a centrifugal force, and by this centrifugal force the water from the SAM, or maybe liquid from the SAM, can be delivered to the desired tank. So this is the main component of a centrifugal pump. So let's talk about the work done by the impeller of a centrifugal pump. Before going to that, let's assume certain assumptions are there. So let's try to understand one by one the assumptions. Liquid enters the impeller eye in a radial direction, and the wheel component, this is VW1, of the inlet absolute velocity V1 is 0. And flow component VF1 equals to the absolute velocity itself. So here VF1 is equal to V1 and alpha is 90. And what are those actually components, we will come later on. No energy loss in the impeller due to friction or eddy formation. Number 3, no loss due to shock at the entry. There is a uniform velocity distribution in the narrow passes from between the adjacent vanes. So this is the velocity diagram of a centrifugal pump. This is called vanes or blade. This is your inlet. This is your outlet. We assume that water or liquid enters radially, meaning is that this alpha is 90 and velocity of wheel will be 0 here, and V1 is equal to VF1. So here this one is the outer and this is the inner diameter of the impeller. Inside the impeller you will find vanes, and after liquid passing through here it will come out like this. Like it is this is the outlet velocity triangle, which is given by this. Those are the components here given here. And let's try to understand what are the components are there. Number 1 is D1. D1 is the diameter of the impeller at the inlet. N is the speed of the impeller in RPM. Omega is the angular velocity, which is given by twice pi n by 60. ui u1 tendential velocity of the impeller at the inlet, which is given by omega r1. D2, diameter of the impeller at the outlet. D2, U2, tangential velocity of the impeller at the outlet. V1, absolute velocity of the water or liquid at inlet. VW1, velocity of wheel at inlet. VR1, relative velocity of the liquid at inlet. VF1, velocity of flow at inlet. Alpha, it is an angle alpha. Angle made by absolute velocity V1. Angle made by absolute velocity V1 at the inlet with the direction motion of the vane. So, this angle is alpha in the velocity diagram. Theta, angle made by the relative velocity Vr1 at the inlet with the direction motion of the vane. So, this is the direction motion of the vane. This angle is theta. V2, VW2, VR2, VF2 and beta and phi are the corresponding value at outlet. So, here in the outlet velocity triangle, you will get phi, this is beta, this is V1, this is VF1, this is VR1. From here to here it is VW2 and from here to here is U. Now, while passing through the impeller, the velocity of wheel changes and there is a change of moment of the momentum. Torque on the impeller is equal to rate of the change of moment of momentum. So, moment of momentum at inlet is zero since VW1 is zero. And momentum and outlet will be W, capital W by Z, V, W2, R2. So, it is basically this velocity into this, this is from here you will get the perpendicular distance, right? So, if you take the moment, then this is the moment of momentum plus this represent mass. This represent mass. Velocity into perpendicular distance, this represent mass. So, W is basically mz. So, work done per second will be equal to torque into angular velocity. So, as you know, for outlet triangle, U2 is equal to omega R2. So, if I put the value here, you will get W by Z VW2 U2. So, work done per second per unit weight of the liquid. Per unit weight means you have to remove this per unit weight of the liquid. So, it will become VW2 U2 divided by Z. So, equation 1 has developed assuming flow at the inlet to be radial where VW1 is equal to 0. If the flow is not radial, then the equation will be work done per second per unit weight will be 1 by Z VW2 U minus VW1 U1. And this equation is called Euler momentum equation for centrifugal pump. So W is the weight of the liquid which is equal to omega into Q. Omega is specific weight, rho g, and Q, that is volume per second, so it is given by pi d1 b1 vf1 is equal to pi d2 b2 vf2, where d1 d2 are the diameter of the impeller, external diameter, internal diameter, where b2 v2 are the widths of the impeller at inlet and outlet. So let's talk about the efficiencies of a centrifugal pump. Number one is monometric efficiency, which is given by monometric head divided by head imparted by the impeller to the liquid, which is given by monometric head, that is H monometric by the work done. Here we are considering inlet. Inlet is radial. So that's why VW1 is 0. That's why here VW1 U1 is not here. Okay. So let's come to volumetric efficiency. So volumetric efficiency is a ratio between liquid discharge per second from the pump by quantity of liquid passing per second through the impeller. So it is given by capital Q plus small q. So capital Q is the actual liquid discharge at the pump outlet per second, and small q is the leakage of the liquid per second from the impeller. Let's come to mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency is the power delivered by the impeller to the liquid by power input to the pump shaft, that is P. So overall efficiency is power output of the pump divided by power input to the pump, and it can be given by, overall efficiency can be given by monometric efficiency into volumetric efficiency into mechanical efficiency. So those are the few parameters where by finding those parameters you can find out the characteristic of a centrifugal pump. So in the next class we try to solve few problems on centrifugal pump. I hope you understand. Thank you. Stay safe.